Hi, this is Dirk with Remodel AI. I'm going to give a quick walkthrough of a basic interior remodel, and then I'm going to show some of the more advanced features. I'm on a tablet right now, so if you're on your phone, the layout may be slightly different, but it's very similar. So I'm going to jump right in, just click on interior remodel. The first step is just choosing your starting image. It's pretty self-explanatory. You can choose from your image gallery, you can take a picture with your phone, or you can choose one of the samples. A little advice before we just pick one and move on, the cleaner your room, the better. The reason that is because the AI is gonna build a three-dimensional map of your existing room, and it's gonna try to more or less match that with the resulting image. So if you have a lot of clutter on desktops, and countertops and things like that, like plants and purses, it's gonna struggle to figure out what to do with those three-dimensional shapes. So better results when it tends to be cleaner. You'll notice the samples tend to be fairly clean and clear clutter. There's no toothbrushes and soap and things like that. Another tip is if you need to crop or you wanna use a different aspect ratio, you can go to the advanced and then you can choose an image that way. And that allows you to crop and possibly change the shape of your image. So you can do all sorts of different custom sizes. You can zoom in as well if you want to do, you know, a subset of the room. But if you just want to use an image, just go back to the simple one. But if you want to crop or resize or change the aspect ratio, go to advanced. So I'm going to use one of the sample images just so you guys can replicate this if you want to follow along. I'm just going to click on the first sample image. And then we'll move on to the interior remodel. And this is the interior remodel step. Now this is where you're gonna do all the work to remodeling your room. Before we jump too much into the settings, I'm just gonna go over here and click generate with the default modern style. And here you can see it's created actually four images of different style modern kitchens based on that kitchen. So you can see down here which image you're on. You can also click to see the grid if you want to see all four at the same time. And you can also toggle the input on and off if you want to switch between the new and the old. And that was just with the preset style of modern. There's all sorts of different presets available, so feel free to explore these. And each time you hit generate, you're gonna get four new images. So don't be afraid to just hit generate several times using the same style and discover what you like. If you need something more advanced, there's also something called custom style. And here you can actually write a completely custom prompt. Granite countertops, dark cabinets. And here you can see it gave us more or less the same modern style, but it darkened up the cabinets a little bit, a nice stainless fridge. There it did more granite because we specified granite. I like the nice waterfall, although we probably want a waterfall on that side. More dark cabinets, dark granite countertops. This is white granite. So a couple different options. And again, don't be afraid to just hit generate several times and see what you like. It keeps generating random images each time you hit generate. On the process of writing this, what's called the prompt, we use the same model called Clip, the AI model, to parse this prompt that a lot of popular AI models use. So if you go online, there's a couple websites. I like prompthero.com. You can search for beautiful modern kitchen, and you can see all sorts of different prompts that people have used to generate images. And you can actually copy those prompts and then paste them here. Now the images that result will be a little bit different because they're going to look like your kitchen, not just some random kitchen. And additionally, the model we use is different, but it can still give you some ideas about different prompts to use. You can use artist name, you can use architect's names, you can use product names, you can really put anything in here. Prompts can be quite long. So don't be afraid to be a little bit creative and spend some time trying out all sorts of different things. Now jumping over to the third way of rendering images, you can use a source style image. Now what that basically means is it's gonna take your starting kitchen and it's gonna apply a style from an image. So you can load an image. So if you go on Pinterest or whatever and download kitchens you love, there's also a couple samples in here. I'll just use one sample again so you can replicate this. So we're gonna click this sample image. Now this kitchen has, let's see, blue cabinets, white countertops, wood floor. It's gonna try to pull those elements and put them into your kitchen. So let's just hit generate. And here you can see it's generated a kitchen from this style. So it copied the elements I was talking about, blue cabinets, wood floor, stainless stove. Now it didn't have a fridge in the original style photo, so it probably just decided, hey, you know, the fridge needs to match the stove, so it made it stainless. And all the images look pretty similar. Again, you can hit generate and create four new ones, but it's gonna try to do this style every time. So this is a great tool if you find an image you love online, just wanna see what it looks like in your room. I'm gonna jump back to presets. And I'm gonna start over by just generating four new images of modern kitchens, and then I'm gonna jump into some of the more advanced features. And here you can see our four resulting images. That's a lot of white. That's interesting with a black accent wall. Let's work with this one. So let's say you find an image you love. Well, the first thing I would do is just hit save. That's gonna save it to your image gallery on your phone so you can go back and load it later. But the other thing I would always recommend before finalizing an image is hitting the upscale button. And this process will take a while, but what essentially it'll do is it'll create a much larger image at a higher resolution, and it'll also go back in and add lots of details to the existing details. And here you can see the resulting image added a lot of detail to the granite or porcelain tiles up here as well. And then it's just a lot sharper. The resolution of the image is much higher. So before you finalize an image, I'd recommend giving upscale a try and then saving that as well. A couple more advanced settings that may be useful. One is just the room type. 99% of the time, this is already going to be correct because it's going to correctly predict using AI what type of room you've uploaded. But if your room isn't listed here, you can use room generic. So if it's a spa or a barbershop or something that's not your typical room, use room generic. Now, if you're using custom prompt, it doesn't matter because you can specify the room type in there. So you could say a yoga studio or whatever if you're using custom prompt. So this is just gives you better results if you're using the presets. Another very useful tool is called masking. Essentially, it allows you to retain a certain area of an image or specify that you only want a certain area changed. So let's say you're doing a remodel and you don't want to change the ceiling or you don't want to change the floor. What you could do is say, I want to retain the painted area in this case, and then you paint in the area that you don't want changed. Now, this is a terrible linoleum floor, so you probably wouldn't want to save it, but if you did, you could paint it and say, I don't want any of this area of the image to be changed. Now, what that's going to do is just force the AI model to deal with it. Now, it'll try to deal with the borders as best as possible, so you don't need to get every square inch. Probably don't want to restrict that area. So I do something like that so that it keeps this. It'll figure out these border errors. And then you just hit accept, and then you generate a new image with that. So let's just show real quick what happens when we do that. And here you can see the resulting kitchens with the same exact floor in all the photos. So great tool, used a lot for also exterior remodels. If you say, I don't want to change the driveway, I don't want to change my lawn, just to give you a way to say, keep this area of an image or only change this area of an image. A couple more advanced settings. I'm gonna get rid of the mask. We don't want to keep that terrible linoleum floor. Fidelity. So what fidelity means is how close should the resulting images match your room? Now, if you turn fidelity all the way up, the AI model is going to try to match your room as much as possible, but at the expense of artistic freedom and variance. The images will kind of look the same. So 0.65 is a great value where you'll get a kitchen or a room that's like your room, but the AI model has a little bit of artistic freedom. If you go all the way down, it's not going to try to match your room at all. In fact, I'll show you what that does. So let's just click generate. And here you'll see, hey, that's a nice kitchen. That's a nice kitchen as well. That's a cool kitchen. These have nothing to do with our original kitchen, though. That's because the fidelity is zero. So you can see if you give the AI a lot of freedom, hey, it'll generate a great modern kitchen. It just won't have any barren resemblance to your actual kitchen. So let's go back to advanced settings. So the values I like are 0.65. That's going to match your kitchen pretty closely, but give it a little freedom. Or things like 0.3. And what that'll do is essentially it'll say, hey, I want more or less to match my kitchen, but you're allowed to change some things. So it might move an island, move a wall, add a window. So it might make some major changes in this case, but it gives a little bit more artistic freedom. So depending on the type of remodel that you're doing, this might be a better option. So that's neat. It got rid of this doorway. I don't think we want that major of a change. It added a light up here, a skylight. That's really cool. It did keep this doorway, added a window up here. That may not be an external wall, but the AI, again, doesn't know that. And we've given it a lot of freedom to change the room around. That one's pretty accurate to change this quite drastically and kind of got rid of the fridge. And this one, again, it got rid of the door. So you can play with these values to say, you know, how much freedom do you want to give the AI model? Often you can get much better results by giving it a little bit more freedom, but it will match your room a little bit less. And a couple last tips before signing off. You can review all this information in the help, what all the different settings do. You can also use this more button and you can send this resulting images to other things. So let's say I want to replace this plant or make other changes or change the flooring or change the walls. You can jump directly to those workflows right from here and change those items without saving it and reloading it. So thank you for joining us. Hopefully you learned a little bit and give me some feedback if there's something you'd like me to cover. Thank you.